there is an outer cover and an inner cover. So oranges have a cover and then the flesh inside. Many fruits are of that type. Some fruits can be eaten with the cover, some have to be peeled. The Quran talks about the intellect as having an outer cover and an inner, purer, more nourishing, more beneficial, more effective flesh. Ulul albab are those whose lub, albab is a plural of lub, lub meaning the internal, interior flesh. Those who have purified it, those who are not tainted or contaminated by lowly animal desires which cloud, and then you can't see, you can only see very little of the truth beyond the aql. It's clouded, it hampers our ability to understand what is right, what is wrong, what is true, what is false. We tend to be biased and prejudiced, and because we may be selfish or greedy, we tend to consider only that particular understanding or perception or interpretation which accords and conforms to our lowly desires. Lob is the one which enables us to understand the pure message. Fasting, one of the advantages is it breaks the cloud. Opens the cloud, and we'll be able to recite the Quran in a more clearer way, and therefore learn from the lessons in a better way. So with this introduction, and there are other reasons why these stories are mentioned. So in several surahs, Allah tells the Holy Prophet, don't you think you are alone in facing opposition and rejection and ridicule from the mushrikeen? Messengers who came before you also faced the same predicament. Let me give you examples, and then the stories of the previous prophets are mentioned. Or no, sometimes it's solace and consolation and comfort for the believers and the followers whose faith is yet weak and in the beginning stages, and they may face persecution and torment and suffering and arrest and deprivation and attacks, and God forbid, even can be killed. So to these believers also, the stories of the past messengers and the supporters of those messengers versus the opponents is a source of solace, that how finally then the believers in the truth were granted victory, and how the opponents of truth, the deniers and the defiers of truth, were then destroyed. So one of those prophets mentioned is Hud alayhi salam. I'm sorry, I could not manage to prepare the slide, so I'm going to ask you to use your imagination. Dar es Salaam, you go straight north and you will reach Mecca. The Qibla is almost the north from Dar es Salaam. And when you reach Mecca, you'll also reach Masjid al-Haram. And when you reach Masjid al-Haram, you'll find the Kaaba. And in the Kaaba, there are four corners. Can you figure out which corner we are facing from Dar es Salaam? Is it Hajar al-Aswad, or Rukn Iraqi, or Rukn Shami, or Rukn Yamani? You're called Rukn Yamani because Yamani is towards facing the south, and we are facing from the south to the north. Okay, now expand your imagination. North of Mecca, and we're going towards Sham. South of Mecca, and we're coming towards Yemen. There used to be a community that lived around the Yemen area before the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These were the people of Aad. It is said that they were between Hadramut and Oman, somewhere towards the Rub' al-Khali, and the terrain and the desert geography is described in the Quran as the Ahqaf, the sand dunes. Hiqf is a elevation of sand. Ahqaf, there's a whole surah named after these people. And there is a whole surah named after the Prophet who went to them, Hud alayhi salam. So there are many surahs in which the name of the Prophet and the name of the people has appeared. In many surahs, there is just the mention of the Prophet and the people separately. So for example, in Surah Hud, chapter 11, verse number 51 to 60, there's the whole story in a paragraph about these people. Or for example, in Surah A'raf, chapter 7, verses number 65 to 72, again, a whole paragraph about these people. Or in Surah Mubarakah, Ash-Shu'ara, chapter 26, verse number 123 till 140, there is a whole paragraph about them. These are the longest three paragraphs about these people. In other surahs, you'll find brief mention, 2 verses, 3 verses, 4 verses only, not 10, 20 verses. So for example, in Surah Zariyat, chapter 51, there are 2 verses. Or in Surah Qamar, there are 4 verses. Or in Surah Mubarakah, Haqqah, chapter 69, there are 6 verses. And then there's a third group of surahs where there is no long mention or medium mention. There's only a mention in one ayah, just a single ayah, about these people. So for example, and these names appear not only in the Makki surahs, but also in the Madani surahs. So for example, in Surah Mubarakah, Ya Tawbah, which is a Madani surah, perhaps one of the later surahs, if not the last surah revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, there's one ayah, Surah Tawbah. Or in Surah Ibrahim, or in Surah Hajj, or in Surah Furqan, or in Surah Ankabut, which we'll be reciting inshallah on Laylatul Qadr. There's hardly a mention of 1 or 2 verses. Or in Surah Sa'd, or Surah Mu'min Ghafir, or Surah Qaf, chapter 50, or Surah Najm, chapter 53, and of course the famous Surah in the Juz 30, and you'll find a good description of the people of Ad because it's there in Juz 30, Surah Al-Fajr, Alam Tara Kaifa Fa'ala Rabbuka بعاد إرم ذات العماد التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. 3-4 verses in the last juz. Good description appears here. So I'll give you a brief outline based on one of the surahs where there's a long description, and then we try to see what lessons we can learn from them. So for example, in Surah Mubarakah Shu'ara, there's a long description, ayah number 123 to ayah number 140. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Kazzabat 'Adun al-mursaleen. O Prophet, remember the story of the people of Ad who rejected the messenger. Hey, I made a mistake in the translation. Did you pick it up? كذبت عاد المرسلين. The people of Ad rejected not Hud alayhi salam only, they rejected all the messengers. Kwanini, Kosoabu, you will find when you read the stories of all these different messengers, there are some surahs where the stories of several messengers has been mentioned in detail. So for example, Surah A'raf, or Surah Shu'ara, or Surah Mu'minun. And one theme that keeps on repeating itself is this messenger went to these people and he said, Ani'budullah. All of them brought one single message. All of them said that you must accept the messenger. All of them said you must accept the message that has come from God and practice taqwa. You reject one, you reject everybody else who brought these messages because they have this commonality. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسوله no ورسله. We as Muslims are supposed to believe in all the messengers who came before. You reject one imam, you have rejected all the 12 imams. They have a common message, common source, common message, common purpose. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ هُودٌ أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Remember when he came to his people, Hud alayhi salam advised them that, oh my people, I'm not a stranger, I'm not an outsider, he said. I'm your brother. I'm your brother. He could have been a relative from the people of Aad. Or no, I'm your brother, meaning I'm your social, moral brother. I'm not here as a dictator. You must obey me. No, I'm your brother. I share your concerns. I hear, I listen to you. I live with you. You have seen me, my morality, my integrity, my character, my lifestyle. And I'm concerned for you, just like any brother would be concerned. We are all equals. So listen to me. A very respectful approach the messengers had to their people. أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. The doctor came and told us there are certain lifestyle behaviors we need to avoid. Kwanini. Well, you'll have 8 golden rules from every doctor who comes. At the end of the, I don't know how many golden or silver rules we'll end up having. Well, the messengers also came with golden rules. Ala tattaqoon. Why don't you guard yourself against those behaviors which are going to harm you? Apply your common sense. I am a well-wisher. I'm an expert. I'm reminding you, the Prophet says. Inni lakum rasulun amin. I've come as a trustworthy messenger. I've got a message. I'm not adding to it. I'm not subtracting to it. I'm not misinterpreting it. I'm not being selective. The way the message was given to me, trust me, I'm delivering it to you. And yeah, I've lived with you for so many years. You know my integrity and my honesty. Fattaqullah. I again remind you, I warn you, beware of those behaviors which are harmful. Wa ati'uni, and follow me. I cannot give you everything in writing. There are many things I have to talk to you, explain to you, elucidate for you. So you have to come and follow me. I have to practically demonstrate how to live. Come and follow me and obey me. Ah, mdanganyifu, sasa tutakwenda kwake, atatuambia, lete kuku na mayai, na so you give me some money and I'll solve your problems. وَمَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرِ. I don't ask for you any payment from you. كَوَنِينِ إِنْ أَجْرِيَ إِلَّا عَلَى رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. There's a creator I have, a nourisher, at a time when nobody of you was there, he nourished me. And he is going to continue. I do my duty, he will help me. He will guide me. I don't need any. So don't feel the burden, oh, we have to pay him. Well, incidentally, the same logic was used by the جَاءَ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى. He used the same logic. Why don't you follow these messengers who have come? They are not asking for any ajr. And the bona fide certification of a true versus a fake leader. The fake leader is going to expect you to pay. The true leader says, I've come here to help you, to guide you. So if you're ready to listen to me, Prophet Hud alayhi salam says, I have some guidance to give you. Before I continue with Surah Shu'ara, in Surah Mubarakah A'raf, the ayah starts by saying that he told them that you must believe in tawheed. أن اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره. That you should obey God and God alone. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu you, by your fitra, you believe there is a God. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them who created, is it these idols whom you worship or it's Allah? They will tell you, yes, Allah is the creator. Yet for their daily problems, I want more rizq, I want this sickness to go away, I want this disaster to go away, I'm going for business, I want my agricultural produce to and harvest to be bumper, they go to the idols. So Hud alayhi salam says, مَا لَكُم مِّن إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُ. There is no entity worthy of worship and respect and adoration and submission and love and prayer to and hope and fear from other than Allah. Nobody else has that power. Everybody else is powerless. أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. The community was being led by certain elite group. That elite group led the opposition to the messenger. قَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. The leading rich, successful, powerful people, they are the ones who rejected. They said, إِنَّا لَنَرَاكَ فِي سَفَاهَا. We see that you are a good man otherwise. You lived with us, we liked you, but now you're speaking some things which don't make sense. It's a bit foolish what you're telling us. We should leave our idols. It's foolish. No, worse than that. Inna lanadhunnuka minal kadhibin. We think you're lying to us. Not in this, but elsewhere. It seems you're jealous of our power. Tomorrow you want to come and replace us and take our position of leadership. No, we don't believe in you because we think you're a liar. Hud alayhi salam does not get angry in response. He very gently, respectfully, but firmly and logically responds to them. Qala ya qawm laysa bi safaha. Interestingly, he doesn't answer the elite. He's talking to the people. Let me explain to you. You are listening to these false, misguided leaders who are abusing the God-given bounties, who are not having taqwa, who are using it for selfish reasons, and who are damaging themselves and the community and the environment. No, don't listen to them. Let me explain to you the accusation they're making against me, the Prophet, that I am not wise and intelligent and sane. These words are insane. They're stupid. He says that, laysa bi safaha. That's not true. Very respectful. So you call me an animal. No, I'm not an animal. I'm a human being. I have all the signs of a human being in me. Walakinni rasulun min rabbil alamin. I'm a messenger and I have the proof that I'm a messenger. Look at the proof. Don't listen to the propaganda. Consider every accusation and every information you get from any source. What is the veracity and the validity and the credibility of that report? Apply your logic. This is what Hud alayhi salam is teaching the people. أُبَلِّغُكُمْ رِسَالَاتِ رَبِّي وَأَنَا لَكُمْ نَاصِحْ. Ameen. I am delivering God's message to you. I am a well-wisher, I am trustworthy. أَوَعَجِبْتُمْ نَسْتَعْجَابُ أَوَعَجِبْتُمْ أَنْ جَاءَكُمْ ذِكْرٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِّنْكُمْ. What's your problem? You expect guidance to come in the form of some angel hovering or some book dropping from the sky. This is not the way Allah chooses His messages. Or you want a dream and there you get a message from God. This is not how he communicates. Everything has a mechanism, a procedure. Dreams are not given to everyone. Angels are not sent to everyone. You need receptivity. And only a few attain that degree of purity to become receptive to the pure divine messages. So he has chosen me, Hud alayhi salam says, وَاذْكُرُوا إِذْ جَعَلَكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَوْمِ نُوحٍ. You people in the Middle East, remember the focus of all the stories in the Quran is the Middle East. There is no mention of communities in Africa or other parts of Asia or Latin America or North America. God has sent a community there and destroyed them. Why be North America? North America. It was discovered by Columbus. It existed before, but mankind seems to have discovered it, at least part of it, centuries later. No, so the Quran, there are definitely stories about communities elsewhere. But the focus is on the Middle East, because that's where the evidence is very clear for the audience. They can easily travel to the north, towards Sham, and they'll see the ruins of certain communities. They can easily go to the south, Yemen, and they will see ruins of other communities there. So you saw, Hud alayhi salam says, that after Nuh alayhi salam and the flood that destroyed the whole community except for a few mu'mineen, that now you have been made khalifa, you have made successors and given the task of receiving God's bounties and using it in God's ways so you can flourish and get felicity here in the dunya. إِذْ جَعَلَكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَوْمِ نُوحٍ وَزَادَكُمْ فِي الْخَلْقِ بَسْطَةً. And Allah has given you abundance in your health. If the doctor was there, I think he would not have found chronic kidney diseases in that community. Allah says, بَسْطَةً. He gave them a lot of health, gave them long life, gave them strength, physical strength, gave them prosperity, the farm and the economic success was granted to them. فَذْكُرُوا آلَىٰ أَللَّهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Now that you've got so much abundance, you're so powerful, you're so rich, you're so successful, you're so healthy, you're so wealthy. All these are bounties from God. Yes, you made the efforts, but it was God's fadl that granted you. Recognize He is the bestower. Recognize this as a bestowal, and therefore use it to please Him, and He'll give you more. What did they do? I'm pausing here, Surah A'raf. I'm going back to Surah Shu'ara to give you a picture now. What is it that they ended up doing? In Surah Shu'ara, Hud alayhi salam tells them, what is the problem with you? أَتَبْنُونَ بِكُلِّ رِيعٍ آيَةً تَعْبَثُونَ. Ayah number 128. What's the problem with you? With all these bounties God gave you, with all this strength, you are misusing it and wasting it. You're building these huge structures on every height. Remember, they were in Ahqaf. Ahqaf were these elevations. Look at the satellite image of the Rub' al-Khali, and between Rub' al-Khali and Yemen and Hadramut, you'll see the sand dunes. On every elevation, you build up some high structure. Ta'abathun. Not for any good, beneficial reason, just for vain delight. Any structure built which is unnecessary, which is useless, just for amusement, just because you've got the money, just because you've got the resources, just because you have the strength, this is abuse, this is misuse. Hud alayhi salam is saying, this is not shukr of Allah. Next, وَتَتَّخِذُونَ مَصَانِعَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَخْلُدُونَ. And then you're building structures, forget about the heights, monuments on the heights, towers on the heights. No, even on the plain ground, you're building structures and strongholds and fortresses and mansions and castles. Sorry, one translator has said that, and you're building factories. I doubt if factory would be an appropriate translation of masani'. Yes, in the Arabic today, factory is masna', plural is masani'. But the Quranic Arabic, masani' is what you build, this great structure, be it a mansion, be it a castle, be it a fortress, be it a stronghold. And look at these huge which castles you're building? You need to stay in one or two rooms. What do you need 10, 20, 40 rooms for? Huge structures. Kwa nini? La'allakum takhludun? You seem to have forgotten there's an akhirah. You think you're going to stay here forever? Structures and any activity where we use God's given resources for a purpose should not make us forget that there's an akhirah and there's an accountability. Number three, Hud alayhi salam says, وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ. Oh, you're powerful physically. You've got resources. So now you've got a lot of power. And when you use that power and you attack others and you pounce upon others and you assault others and you seize upon others, you do it violently like tyrants in a destructive way. Excessive, disproportionate use of force. Yamani, you think this is only people of Aad? Just open the news today and see what's happening today. You think Prophet Hud alayhi salam came with a message that this Quran is 1,000 years old, doesn't apply to us today? Why did the Quran repeat the story again and again and again? Whole paragraphs, 3-4 verses, one single verse, so many surahs. Kwa nini? There's something about the human being which, if it does not come under the controlling, supervision, management, modulation of a divine messenger, there's uncontrolled, excessive abuse, which not only harms themselves, it harms everyone. We are being told that yesterday, every minute, how many limbs are cut off because of diabetes. Yamani, the same time period, their kids dying because of no fault of theirs. They are being killed. They are being starved. This is not history. This is living story talking to us by a living God who knows the human psychology and the human weaknesses. وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونِ. And therefore, me as a messenger from God, Hud alayhi salam, says, listen to my advice and follow God's laws. Kwanini, why should I follow him? It is all my effort. I have worked hard. Bongo hi, imefanya kazi. This is how I got success. So Hud alayhi salam says, وَاتَّقُوا الَّذِي أَمَدَّكُمْ بِمَا تَعْلَمُونَ. All this is madad from Allah. أَمَدَّكُمْ بِأَنْعَامٍ وَبَنِينَ وَجَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. He's given you all these resources. And beware, my final message to you, Hud alayhi salam, إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. I fear you continue abusing, you continue breaking the law. The law is going to come and break you one day. I fear that. Their response, Asante sana, tumeghaflika, tumelala kabisa. Hey, daktari, asante, hatujayua. You think this is how Aad responded to Hud alayhi salam? Aad said, sawa'un alayna. أَوَعَظْتَ أَمْ لَمْ تَكُنْ مِنَ الْوَاعِظِينَ. مَوْئِزَ مَوْئِزَ بَوْكَرُ وَشُتَمِ. Whether you preach and teach and lecture and advise and admonish, we're not going to listen. We don't accept what you're saying. We don't even accept you're a messenger. We don't accept your message. We don't accept you're a messenger. What are you trying to tell us? What are you trying to warn us? What punishment? This is success. It's all our efforts. وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمُعَذَّبِينَ. No, we're not going to be punished. These are the warta ucheta meliaucho suapne daraucho Nuh. This is what happened to Nuh alayhi salam. And in هَذَا إِلَّا خُلُقُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. These are fables. These are fabrications of these primitive old people. They didn't have progress. عَاد was one of the most successful civilizations, technologically advanced. Irama, ذات العماد, the city of pillars, huge monumental architectural wonders, التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. There was no other advanced technology like them and civilization like them. So they said, tell us where else you'll find people like us. من أشد منا قوة? Who is the superpower other than us? عاد. Story ends by just one ayah. فكذبوا فأهلكناهم. They continued in their rejection, repudiation, renouncement, defiance, opposition, accusation. You're a liar. This message is not true. You're not a messenger. There's no azab. They're living in a sea of sand. The sand particles were ordered. A storm was created. And then in Surah Mubarakiyah, Haqqa, Allah describes what happened to them. Chapter 69. Of course, other verses also discuss this, but I'm just quoting Surah Haqqa. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa amma 'ad fa uhliku bi rihin sarsarin 'atiyah. A wind storm came and attacked them. Sarsar. Though Yemen would be a hot area, but this was an icy gale, bitter cold wind. But it was atiya, excessively powerful. But I have masani', I have strongholds and fortresses and castles. I don't know if you've been to, there's one of the South African cities, Durban. I was invited as a guest. So I say, Sheikh, we'll give you a flat just opposite the sea. So it's not like the sea here in Dar es Salaam. Those Durban shores have got terrible storms. Usiku ghafla naamka. The whole window is shaking. There's a powerful gale. These people were sent an icy, bitter, icy cold gale. سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا. Continuously, tirelessly, unstoppably, incessantly, they continued. For 8 days and 7 nights, you resisted day one, day two, day three. One by one, you succumb. Final result is, فَتَرَى الْقَوْمَ فِيهَا صَرْعَى كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٍ. How can I show you and illustrate for you practically the total destruction? God says, have you seen, look at these strong standing date palm trees. Once they get uprooted and they fall, this is how you would find these healthy hulks, monsters, all fallen down. Kwanini. Ya Allah, you gave them everything, all this madad, and then finally you just uproot them and destroy them. The answer. Surah Mubarakah Yasin. Ya hasratan ala al-ibad. It's a pity. It's a regret. It's a big sorrow. Messengers came again and again. Incidentally, it was not only Hud alayhi salam, other messengers also came. They came again and again. They had reminders. They had explanation. They had reasonable arguments being made towards them. But they simply chose to ignore. So after repetitive guidance, when it reaches a point of no return, now they tell you, sikiliza, nyamaza sasa, hatutakusikiliza, nenda zako. They reach that point. Don't lecture us anymore. It's going to be the same. When they reach this point, not one or two, the whole community, of course, except for the few. That is the time when God's mercy then is lifted. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٍ. In the story of Hud alayhi salam, and the people of Ad, there's a clear sign. The sign that how people can misuse their intelligence, they can misuse their emotions, they can misuse their physical bounties, they can misuse their economic prosperity, they can begin to doubt the clear message, they can deny the divine message. إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَآيَةٌ وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ Majority of them refuse to accept. If you refuse to accept, remember, you do not rule history. You know, there are some powers, superpowers, they say, aha, let's sit and predict the future. What's going to happen in the future? They say, predict the future. We will create the future. Allah says, no, you can't create the future. Allah is the one who governs history. Allah is the one who rules history. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ O Prophet, your Rabb today, the same Rabb in the past, the same Rabb till the end. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزِ He's the Almighty, the irresistible, unconquerable, who can never be overpowered. But his might doesn't show immediately. Ar-Rahim, he's very merciful. Again and again and again, he reminds. He kept the door open. Incidentally, this ayah of Istaghfiru Rabbakum, that seek forgiveness, has also been mentioned by Hud alayhi salam in Surah Hud to his people. The door is open. Come back and seek forgiveness. Not only God is Ghafir, he forgives. He's Ghafoor, he'll forgive all sins. Not only is he Ghafoor, he's Ghaffar. Even if you do your sins again and again and again, he will forgive. Let's pray to Allah to be able to learn the lessons, which are not history. Those lessons are happening even today. Let's pray we get the tawfiq to be able to reform and transform ourselves. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم يا علي يا عظيم يا غفور يا رحيم أنت الرب العظيم الذي ليس كمثلي شيء وهو السميع البصير. وهذا شهر عظمته وكرمته وشرفته وفضلته على الشهور، وهو الشهر الذي فرضت صيامه علي، وهو شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، وجعلت فيه ليلة القدر وجعلتها خيرا من ألف شهر. فيا ذا المن ولا يمن عليك، من علي بفكاك رقبتي من النار فيما أنت من عليه، وأدخل للجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم رب شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن وافترضت على عبادك فيه الصيام، صل على محمد وآل محمد، وارزقني حج بيتك الحرام في عامي هذا وفي كل عام، واغفر لي تلك الذنوب العظام فإنه لا يغفرها غيرك يا رحمن يا رحمن يا علام. اللهم إني أفتتح الثناء بحمدك وأنت مسدد للصواب بمنك، وأيقنت أنك أنت أرحم الراحمين في موضع العفو والرحمة، وأشد المعاقبين في موضع النكال والنقمة، وأعظم المتجبرين في موضع الكبرياء والعظمة. اللهم أذنت لي في دعائك ومسألتك فاسمع يا سميع مدحتي، وأجيب يا رحيم دعوتي، وأقيل يا غفور عسرتي. فكم يا إلهي من كربة قد فرجتها، وهموم قد كشفتها، وعثرة قد أقلتها، ورحمة قد قد نشرتها وحلقتي بلاء قد فككتها الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا الحمد لله بجميع محامده كلها على جميع نعمه كلها الحمد لله الذي لا مضاد له في ملكه ولا منازع له في أمره الحمد لله الذي لا شريك له في خلقه ولا شبيه له في عظمته الحمد لله الفاشي في الخلق أمره وحمده الظاهر بالكرم مجده الباسط بالجود يده الذي لا تنقص خزائنه ولا تزيد كثرة العطاء إلا جودا وكرما إنه هو العزيز الوهاب اللهم إني أسألك قليلا من كثير ما حاجة بي إلي عظيما وغناك عنه قديم وهو عندي كثير وهو عليك سهل يسير اللهم إنا عفوك عن ذنبي وتجاوزك عن خطيئتي وصفحك عن ظلمي وسترك على قبيح عملي وحلمك عن كثير جرمي عندما كان من خطئي وعمدي أطمعني في أن أسألك ما لا أستوجبه منك الذي رزقتني من رحمتك وأريتني من قدرتك وعرفتني من إجابتك فصرت أدعوك آمنا وأسألك مستأنسا لا خائفا ولا وجلا مدلا عليك فيما قصدت فيه إليك فإن أبطى عني عتبت بجهلي عليك ولعل الذي أبطى عني هو خير لي لعلمك بعاقبة الأمور فلم أر مولا كريما أصبر على عبدي اللئيم منك علي يا ربي إنك تدعوني فأولي عنك وتتحبب إلي فأتبغض إليك وتتودد إلي فلا أقبل منك كأن لي التطول عليك فلم يمنعك ذلك من الرحمة لي والإحسان إلي والتفضل علي بجودك وكرمك فارحم عبدك الجاهلاً وجد علي بفضل إحسانك إنك جواد كريم. الحمد لله مالك الملك مجري الفلك مسخر الرياح فالق الإصباح دين الدين رب العالمين. فالق الإصباح ديان الدين رب العالمين. الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه والحمد لله على عفوه بعد قدرته والحمد لله على طول أناته في غضبه وهو قادر على ما يريد. الحمد لله خالق الخلق باسط الرزق فالق الإصباح ذي الجلال والإكرام والفضل والإنعام الذي بعدا فلا يرى وقربا فشهد النجوى تبارك وتعالى. الحمد لله الذي ليس له منازع يعادله ولا شبيه يشاكله ولا ظهير يعاضده قهر بعزته الأعزاء وتواضع لعظمته العظماء فبلغ بقدرته ما يشاء. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه. فكم من موهبة هنيئة قد أعطاني وعظيمة مخوفة قد كفاني وبهجة مونقة قد أراني فأثني عليه حامدا وأذكره مسبحا. الحمد لله الذي لا يهتك حجابه ولا يغلق بابه ولا يرد سائله ولا يخيب آمنه. الحمد لله الذي يؤمن الخائفين وينجي الصالحين ويرفع المستضعفين ويضع المستكبرين ويهلك ملوكا ويستخلف آخرين. والحمد لله قاصم الجبارين مبير الظالمين مدرك الهاربين نكال الظالمين صريخ المستصرخين موضع حاجات الطالبين معتمد المؤمنين. الحمد لله الذي من خشيته ترعد السماء وسكانها وترجف الأرض وعمارها وتموج البحار ومن يسبح في غمراتها. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي يخلق ولم يخلق ويرزق ولا يرزاق ويطعم ولا يطعم ويميت الأحياء ويحيي الموتى وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وأمينك وصفيك وحبيبك وخيرتك من خلقك وحافظي سرك ومبلغي رسالاتك أفضل وأحسن وأجمل وأكمل وأزكى وأنمى وأطيب وأطهر وأسنى وأكثر ما صليت وباركت وترحمت وتحننت وسلمت على أحد من عبادك وأنبيائك ورسلك وصفوتك وأهل الكرامة عليك من خلقك اللهم وصل على علي أمير المؤمنين ووصي رسول رب العالمين عبدك ووليك وأخي رسولك وحجتك على خلقك وآيتك الكبرى والنبأ العظيم وصل على الصديقة الطاهرة فاطمة سيدة نساء العالمين وصل على سبطي الرحمة وإمامي الهدى الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي حججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائمة اللهم وصل على ولي أمرك القائم المؤمل والعدل المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين صل على محمد اللهم اجعله الداعي إلى كتابك والقائم بدينك استخلفه في الأرض كما استخلفت الذين من قبله مكن له دينه الذي ارتضيته لهم أبدله من بعد خوفه أمنا يعبدك لا يشرك بك شيئا يعبدك لا يشرك بك شيئا اللهم أعزه وأعزز به وانصره وانتصر به وانصره نصرا عزيزا وافتح له فتحا يسيرا واجعل له من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا اللهم أظهر به دينك وسنة نبيك حتى لا يستخفيا بشيء من الحق مخافة أحد من الخلق. اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله وتذل بها النفاق وأهله وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم ما عرفتنا من الحق فحملنا وما قصرنا عنه فبلغنا. اللهم المهم به شعثنا واشعب به صدعنا وارتق به فتقنا وكسر به قلتنا وأعزز به ذلتنا وأغن به عائلنا واقض به عن مغرمنا واجبر به فقرنا وسد به خلتنا ويسر به عسرنا وبيض به وجوهنا وفك به أسرنا وأنجح به طلبتنا وأنجز به مواعيدنا واستجب به دعوتنا وأعطنا به سؤلنا وبلغنا به من الدنيا والآخرة آمالنا وأعطنا به فوق رغبتنا يا خير المسؤولين وأوسع المعطين. اشف به صدورنا وأذهب به غيظ قلوبنا واهدنا به لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك. إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم وانصر به على عدوك وعدونا. إلهنا الحق آمين. اللهم إنا نشكو إليك فقد نبينا صلواتك عليه وآله وغيبة ولينا وكثرة عدونا وقلة عددنا وشدة الفتن بنا وتظاهر الزمان علينا. فصل على محمد وآله وأعنا على ذلك بفتحهم منك تعجله وبضر تكشفه ونصر تعزه وسلطان حق تظهره ورحمة منك تجللنا وعافية منك تلبسنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم برحمتك في الصالحين فأدخلنا وفي عليين وارفع فارفعنا وبكأس من معين من عين سلسبيل فاسقنا ومن الحور العين برحمتك فزوجنا ومن الولدان المخلدين كأنهم لؤلؤ مكنون فأخدمنا ومن ثمار الجنة ولحوم الطير فأطعمنا ومن ثياب السندس والحرير والإستبرق فألبسنا وليلة القدر وحج بيتك الحرام وقتلا في سبيلك فوفق لنا وصالح الدعاء والمسألة فاستجب لنا وإذا جمعت الأولين والآخرين يوم القيامة فارحمنا وبراءة من النار فاكتب لنا وفي جهنم فلا تغلنا وفي عذابك وهوانك فلا تبتلنا ومن الزقوم والضريع فلا تطعمنا ومع الشياطين فلا تجعلنا وفي النار على وجوهنا فلا تكتبنا ومن ثياب النار وسرابيل القطران فلا تلبسنا ومن كل سوء يا لا إله إلا أنت بحق لا إله إلا أنت فبحنا يا لا إله إلا أنت فنجنا اللهم أن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر من الأمر المحتوم في الأمر الحكيم من القضاء الذي لا يرد ولا يبدل أن تكتبني من حجاج بيتك الحرام المبرور حجهم المشكور سعيهم المغفور ذنوبهم المكفر عن سيئاتهم وأن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر أن تطيل عمري في خير وعافية وتوسع في رزقي وتجعلني ممن تنتصر به لدينك ولا تستبدل بي غيري أعوذ بجلال وجهك الكريم أن ينقضي عني شهر رمضان أو يطلع الفجر من ليلتي هذه ولك قبلي تبعة أو ذنب تعذبني علي يا ذا الذي كان قبل كل شيء ثم خلق كل شيء ثم يبقى ويفنى كل شيء يا ذا الذي ليس كمثله شيء ويا ذا الذي ليس في السماوات العلى ولا في الأرضين السفلى ولا فوقهن ولا تحتهن ولا بينهن إله يعبد غيره لك الحمد حمدا لا يقوى على إحصائه لا يقوى على إحصائه إلا أنت فصل على محمد وآل محمد صلاة لا يقوى على إحصائها إلا أنت إلهي وقف السائلون ببابك ولاذ الفقراء بجنابك ووقفت سفينة المساكين على ساحل بحر جودك وكرمك يرجون الجواز إلى ساحة رحمتك إلهي إن كنت لا تغفر في هذا الشهر الشريف إلا لمن أخلص لك في صيامه وقيامه فمن للمذنب المقصر إذا غرق في بحر ذنوبه وآثامه إلهي إن كنت لا ترحم إلا المطيعين فمن للعاصين وإن كنت لا تقبل إلا من العاملين فمن للمقصرين إلهي ربح الصائمون وفاز القائمون ونجي المخلصون ونحن عبيدك المذنبون فارحمنا برحمتك وأعتقنا من النار بعفوك يا كريم يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين. اللهم أدخل على أهل القبور السرور اللهم أغني كل فقير اللهم أشبع كل جائع اللهم اكسو كل عريان اللهم اقضي دينا كل مدين اللهم فرج عن كل مكروب اللهم رد كل غريب اللهم فك كل أسير اللهم أصلح كل فاسد من أمور المسلمين اللهم اشف كل مريض اللهم سد فقرنا بغناك اللهم غير سوء حالنا بحسن حالك اللهم اقضي عنا الدين وأغننا من الفقر إنك على كل شيء قدير. سورة الفاتحة إن شاء الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليك يا رسول الله، السلام عليك يا نبي الله، السلام عليك يا حبيب الله، السلام عليك يا خاتم النبيين، السلام عليك يا أمير المؤمنين، السلام عليك يا بنت رسول الله، السلام عليك يا مولاي يا حسن المجتبى، السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله، وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليكم يا شهداء كربلاء جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليك يا مولى وابن مولى، السلام عليك يا غريب الغرباء، السلطان أبا الحسن علي بن موسى الرضا، وعلى أختك فاطمة المعصومة جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليك يا مولانا يا صاحب العصر والزمان، سيدي الأمان والأمان والأمان. السلام عليك يا خليفة الرحمن، السلام عليك يا شريك القرآن، السلام عليك يا كعبة الإيمان، إمامنا وإمام الإنس والجان. عجل الله لك ما وعدك من النصر وظهور الأمر، ورحمة الله وبركاته. مع السلامة.